You know, Muslim law is also known as Islamic law or Mohammedan law. It varies, this terminology varies from region to region. Muslim law is same to Islamic law, whereas Mohammedan law is also the same synonym. Muslim law is a law where majority of the Muslim population will follow it with faithfulness, sincerity and obedience. So with all these adjective qualities, the one who follows the principles of Muslim is known as the follower of Muslim religion. And here we will deal with those rules, those provisions pertaining to the Muslim and their lifestyle. That too, the civil law will be dealt in majority. Civil law. Why I am stressing the civil law? Because for criminality and the criminal laws, the Sharia and the other relevant provisions are there. Whereas we initially, basically deal with civil laws pertaining to the Muslim under this Muslim law. Muslim law comes under family law too. What does it mean? In the previous session, you have studied Hindu law under family law number one. That is family law one is deals with Hindu law, whereas family law two deals with Muslim law. What about other religion sects which are very very distinct to these two? However, why we have chosen this Muslim law under family law too has a unique qualities, characteristic and fundamental differences is there. What are the fundamental differences between the Hindu law and Muslim law that could be easily made out by studying the family law number one and family law number two? So in the second semester of KSLU syllabus, you will find family law 2 for Muslim law. Then, why we have to study Hindu law either in comparison to Muslim law or Muslim law in controversy to the Hindu law? Because it is not controversy, but the principle put forth in the relevant holy scripture of the Muslim law will differ in many aspects, and the follower of those particular principles, they do feel very happy to follow it because of the quality, the essence hidden in the holy book of, say, Muslim, that is Quran. Even today, it is of very, very valuable nature because of its core being most appreciable, communicable. The Quran is, even today, it is the timely tested holy script, not only for the Muslim, for those personalities who do like to follow it, they can follow. The strange thing in the Muslim law, Muslim religion or Muslim code is acceptance of Islamic religion absolutely based on your true acceptance of those principles, comma, and absolute following those principles throughout your life without facing any kind of obstruction, a kind of harassment by any of the other followers. This is the unique nature of Islamic religion and their followers. Why I am saying this principle which is hidden is the Muslim religion is for apostates. What do you mean by apostasy? Apostasy. This is the only one word will attract in total the fellow who want to opt for Muslim religion. What is apostasy? Sir, apostasy. Apostasy is the status quo where you can liberally come out of the clutches of any Muslim hindrances or any problems. So in total you can easily give up the religion voluntarily without anybody's compulsion. This is the apostasy. No other law in the world will go for this apostasy. This is the only one religion which is recommending, advocating the apostasy. It is such a qualitized principle. They have adapted very, very, very initially. Apostasy is the status quo of either corporeal or mind where the aspirant may continue the Muslim religion or practices, or he may come out of the religion voluntarily and to his conveniences. This is the apostasy. No other religion will preach like this. This is the only one religion given room for this apostasy. Practically the scenario is like that or not, that is a different issue of debate. However, apostasy is the word given for those personality who are either to follow the religion code or to give up the religion code. Okay. Muslim law, its origin and development. How it had occurred? Muslim law means Islamic law. How it came into being? So, during 6th century AD after Christ. During 6th century AD in Saudi Arabia, particularly in the region of Medina and Mecca, which was prevailed with such a vast system, community sect, and other mostly comparable to the Hindu status quo. That is, those days, those caste community sects prevailed in the Saudi Arabia nearing to Mecca, Medina, say like that portion, nearly 240 distinct community or sector or caste were prevailed. 240 distinct different types of communities were there during the period nearing to the Muhammad, during the Muhammad era. That is 571 to 632 AD. 571 to 632 AD. This is the life period of Prophet Muhammad. So the origin of Muslim religion took place in the Saudi Arabia, that too in the vicinity nearby Mecca and Medina. Between 571 to 632 AD. It comes under 6th century AD. At that time, nearly 240 communities were settled in that portion, and most of all the community men are following the rituals at par to Hindu religion. Say, all are behind worshipping fire. Worshipping fire. Idols. So these 240 communities at that time were worshipping fire and idols. And in addition to these two main aspects, they are following the lifestyle which is very similar to the Orthodox Hindu in Indian vicinity. Okay, it was the scenario, and their individual personalities like baby, pregnant women, old age personalities, and sick bedridden personalities were treated to an extent inhumanly. Looking at all these aspects, the persons like Muhammad revolt against such practices of those days, and he thought of starting his own sect, saying that one should not be interviewed by such of the practices which often disturb the lifestyle of individual, and also in gaining something good, prosperity in his own lifestyle. So in order to avoid some hindrances which were being followed during the time prior to 571, by nearly 240 communities exist in the Saudi Arabian area, Muhammad thought of originating and giving a propaganda for a new, rational, evolved, with full freedom, society oriented, welfare and other benefited community known as Muslim religion or Islamic religion. What do you mean by Islam? What do you mean by Islam? The word Islam is truly an Arabic word. It says total surrendering of a soul to the God. Total surrendering of one to the Almighty or the God. That is the Islam. Establishment of peace, submission to the will of God. All these true course principles were laid on to form this Islamic religion. So, submission, what is Islam? Coming to this one, what are the principles of Islamic religion? Or to here, what is Islam? Islam, in the religious sense, submission to the will of God. And in though it is a ethnical one, I may say in secular sense, it may be termed as establishment of peace. Establishment of peace. The same word has been even prescribed in Quran also. And following these terms, the religion with God is nothing but a Islam. The religion which is closer to the God, they will say, is nothing but a Islam. And next, they will believe, their faith is that there is only one God, that is Allah. And the preacher of that principle is nothing but a prophet, Muhammad the prophet. So these are the two principles enumerated in the Muslim religion as well as Muslim law. So this is the one thing where the prehistory of origin of Muslim law in Saudi Arabia was due to, not in totality of opposing, but however, to come out of the clutches of that existed 240 communities, those who are primarily worshipping fire and idols during those days. Next, Muhammad the prophet. Muhammad actually very, very innocent person. He's a very innocent person. Well built. He is having a good physique. He took his birth in 571. Posthumous child. His mother took care of the baby. At his age of 6, he lost his mother. And he was looked after by his grandfather by name Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib, M-U-T-T-A-L-I-B. Abdul Muttalib was the grandfather. He looked after the boy, and 2 years later only he also left the world. And later his uncle Abu Talib looked after him. Abu Talib happened to be a merchant man. He is having a very, very good contact with the many merchants of nearby areas. And in his business, Muhammad started helping him. And he rose to very, 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 very attractive position. He rose to very attractive position. so that every businessman used to have contact with Muhammad, and they want to change their attitude and they want to adopt the attitude, character and the other essence of Prophet Muhammad as his, their leader. He was very sincere. He was very neat and tidy. Even his works are to be very, very, very punctual, of trueness and very, very, very good nature. He never had hurt anybody. Every time he want to serve the poor people, and for that he wants to dedicate most of the thing available with him. He is a most disciplinarian person. And he want to do all of his tasks, all of his routine works for himself only, and by himself only. And he never want to take some help from any other. He want to be so very punctual, perfect in his duties, and he has been loved by one and all at that time. He's very, very, very sincere in his duty consciousness. And because of the duty consciousness, since he is a man known for trust, so everybody moved towards him, and has become a core of attraction during those days in the business area also. Okay. When in six, and he used to, and religiously also he is very much motivated, he used to go one place at Medina or Mecca, there was one cave, used to go there often and often, sit there for days together, and being in the meditation, he used to spend all of his days and nights there. And this very particular deed had fetched him revelation. What do you mean by revelation? Yes. What do you mean by revelation? Revelation is the direct contact of a person with the Almighty, having direct contact of a person with the Almighty. This status quo, this scenario is known as revelation. And it was occurred to him. And he became a prophet in 609 AD. In 609 AD, he became a prophet. He started gathering important information of religious code from the messenger of God, and he used to compile those versions into a holy book. Gabriel happened to be the person who came as a representative of God Allah, and he only conveyed the principles of Muslim or Islamic religions to him directly. So that direct contact of a person with a God in order to seek the good messages is known as revelation. What is revelation? They may ask a question like, who is Muhammad? How he became a prophet? And at that time, you have to say this portion. Revelation is the very, very important stage. And coming to today's this topic, then who are all Muslims? So, Islam, those who follow the Islamic code or religion or law, they are known as Muslims. And literally, what do you mean by Muslim? Muslim is a person who is very, very innocent by nature. Muslim is a person who is very, very innocent in nature. That term is adhered to the Muslim. Then what is Islam? Islam is one where a fellow will submit himself in totality to the will of God. That is Islam. What is Muslim? Muslim is an innocent person. So significant. Coming to the Islamic significant. You know, Islam, Islamic. What do you mean Islamic? As-salam. So, the root Islam from which Islam is formed signifies that it is for gaining perfect peace and totally surrendering oneself to the Almighty. This is the Islam. Islam is the total surrendering oneself to the Almighty. And if you surrender, what will happen? You will get peace. You will get safety. You will get a kind of salvation. Everything which are good will come to you when you follow this Islamic codes. Teaching of Islam. Prophet Muhammad regarded religion as a natural law. It's a straight code absolutely applicable to the man being under the influence of a good nature, embedded with all humanities, brotherhood, and with the intention to seek salvation with the Creator or the Almighty. Here, God is very merciful. They will also accept there is one God. And he is not only there simply, but he is very, very merciful. And he shows his mercy to all the men equally and to all the needed hearts. So these are the things which Islam is meant for. Islam is meant for. Coming to overall Muslim, I would like to say Muslims are those personalities who faithfully follows strictly adhere to the codes defined in the holy book, such as Quran, Sunnah, Hadith, Qiyas, and other. So books are there, and those religious books are to define the certain code of humanity that is very much required for all human beings to develop themselves in the society in order to recognize as a true Muslim. So in the family law, under this important introductory portion, we have to deal even with certain other aspects, such as who is a Mohammedan, conversion and its consequences on family, marriage, guardianship, succession, child and family. More than that, the Sharia Act of 1935, sources of Islamic law. Coming to the sources of Islamic law, there are various schools, various sources, concept of marriage, definition, object, nature, essential requirements of a Muslim marriage, classification of marriage, legal effects of void and irregular marriage, types of marriages, inclusive of muta marriages, customary practices and state regulations. These are all the important topics to be covered in the first section of this one. And more than this, polygamy, it also comes under the marriage system of Muslim. Polygamy, often it is inclusive of child marriage, option for puberty, dower, kinds of dower, dower when confirmed, widow, rights of. Yesterday we have gone through the origin, development of Islamic religion under Muslim law. There we have studied how the Muslim religion or Islamic religion has come into being in the vicinity of Saudi Arabia, and who are all the personality inclusive of the great Prophet Muhammad and his allies, who have struggled hard to establish, propagate the religious Islam in the Saudi Arabia. And also we have noted that overall the Muslims. So today I am taking this topic, who is a Muslim? Who are all the Muslims? Why I have chosen this one? Because it is very, very essential, important portion of the syllabus. And as a student, you people might come across very important question even in the examination. Usually they will ask, who is a Muslim? What are his duties? How he will identify as true Muslim? By what way he will be proven to be a true Muslim? So these are all the very important basic portion of the Muslim law, which will lead you to all other sections, provisions, and the chapters of Muslim law for its vast study purpose. So coming to that today's topic, who is a Muslim? In broad sense, we may say, Muslim is a fellow who is a staunch supporter, as well as the follower of codes, its ethics, its etiquette, and essence enumerated in the holy book of Islam, say Quran, and other books. Quran is the prominent one, no doubt. It is the primary source of Islamic religion. With the auspicious 6,666 verses, it has become the holiest. And they will say that this book is of the God's word. So it's the holy. And the content has been sorted out in 114 chapters. And they will call it as Surahs. Ayat, A-Y-A-T, Ayat are the verses, hymns of the Quran. So coming to here, who is a Muslim? Muslim is a person who abides to the sayings of Quran. Is a polite, is a innocent, and he is meant for looking after all the activities as said in the Quran. For you people to brief to such a good answer or reply for this question is, a Muslim is a person who is born to a parent belonging to the Muslim community or religion. A person, a child, born to a parent who truly belongs to Muslim community. This is the first item to be narrated there. So who is a Muslim? Muslim is a person who born to the parent belonging to the Muslim community or Muslim religion. Second, father being a Muslim and mother being a non-Muslim. This is an illustration, that's all. Actually, non-Muslim will not be married to any partner of the Muslim community. For illustration purpose, I will say, if father is a Muslim and mother is a non-Muslim, then the child will be called as a Muslim, provided the activities pertaining to an ideal or true Muslim are being followed even by the child along with the parents. The family circumstances must be like that, should enhance the interest in following the aspects as envisaged to a true Muslim in the Quran text. And another case, when father being a non-Muslim and mother being a Muslim, and she being adorable to the religious aspects very much, and she rare her child to the tune of a Muslim in the family, then that particular child is known as a Muslim. Fourth one. Any non-Muslim voluntarily converted into Muslim. Any non-Muslim voluntarily converted into Muslim and performing those duties meant for a Muslim is known as a Muslim. So by natural birth, one can accept the Muslim religion and he can be proved as a Muslim. Second one, by conversion also, at any time of his life period, he can become a Muslim. I will tell you, apostasy and conversion are the easiest way to accept how a non-Muslim will be converted to Muslim. It is very, very simple. Procedure itself is simplified in a manner that everybody is lauding that one, appreciating that one. That is, if you have made up your mind to become a Muslim, you have to go any mosque, contact the Imam, Qazi, Mullah available there and express your desire. He will make note of it. He will ask you to come next day or the next moment. If you go to him, again he will inquire you whether you are voluntarily been accepting the Muslim religion. If you say yes, 90% of all hindrance will go away. Then that particular mullah or qazi will preach you the kalma. What is kalma? Mere reciting once the kalma is sufficient to prove that you have been converted and you have become a Muslim. Then what is kalma? It is in Arabic verse. It's a hymn. It is in Arabic. It has such a power as per at par to our mantras in Hindu religion. It will convert the gotras. It will convert the caste. It will make you auspicious and it will make you co-join to the new race or religion. Kalma, just very simple, one and a half line, one is La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. This is the verse. You have to tell it once, voluntarily, heartfully. Mere reciting the kalma before a qazi is sufficient to prove that you have become a Muslim. Very simple. Very simple. So kalma will be made, recite by you, and he will change your name. What was to the one synonym to the Muslim religion. He will change from Ram to Rahim. He will change the name. Changing name is a must. He will change the name. and he will enter every particulars of your pre and post datas of conversion in a particular register kept or meant for that purpose, and he will say that you have been converted. It is such a thing. No other tradition, no other culture will get it. It may be there. It may be there for easy identification or any other observation purpose. But mere reciting kalma at any point of your lifetime, wherever you lie, even before Qazi or with other personalities, that is sufficient for conversion. So conversion is the very easiest pattern of accepting the Muslim religion. It is there. So that is the one. Reciting kalma, not only once in life, only at the time of conversion you need not to, although you have to recite the kalma. Kalma is such a pious hymn, you must go on reciting throughout your life for having been a Muslim. So it's a pious mantra, they will say. It should be uttered every day because it will purify your mind, soul and body, and it will encourage you to pursue to achieve the objective which perhaps Almighty would have decided for you. So kalma is the one. A true or ideal Muslim who does this kalma. Kalma is for regular Muslim as well as those who will convert. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. What does it mean? There is one God. He is nothing but Allah. And prophet, be Muhammad being the prophet, he will accept these two voluntarily by heart. Accepting voluntarily by heart that there is God but one Allah, and the Muhammad being the prophet, messenger of the God. Other than that, nothing is there. Kalma is such a strong hymn. Next, namaz. The person who has converted, was born as a Muslim, must have to perform certain of the duties every day, as well as at least once in his few things, at least once in a lifetime, like Hajj and other things. So, after kalma, namaz will come. What is kalma? Here, under Sharia Act only, you will find religious injunction. Under that, there are nearly five categories. One is farz. What is farz? Nothing but duties. That is duties one must accept, one must do, and one must not to get rid of. You must go on having interest, enthusiasm while doing these things. For example, here, as a farz, as an inevitable duty, every Muslim has to undertake namaz 5 times a day. 5 times a day, one Muslim has to perform namaz. What does it mean? Praying the Almighty. Being wherever you like. There is no class saying that you must get into the mosque. Pray before the Qazi. No, not like that. Here to your convenience. You can pray facing to the Mecca, anywhere of your convenient place. So namaz for 5 times a day. It's a must. What is the use? It will purify your mind. It will purify your vision. It will make you a perfect person in the society. Namaz is a kind of purification of oneself. Nobody will give any kind of certificate or so for doing or being done any kind of namaz. But it is at par to our harikatha, bhajan and other celestial ceremonial activities. So namaz is a must. It has no date, but it has a time. Every day one has to go for namaz. And it will purify your mind, soul, also vision. You will become pure. Why you have to become purified? To lead the life luxuriously, comfortably, without giving any hindrance at any point of time to himself or other personalities. Next comes zakat. What is zakat? Zakat is giving alms, A-L-M-S, alms, donation to the poor personalities. Zakat is giving alms or donation to the needy person or poor person or poorer person. This is a must. Not only during festival days or ceremonies, at all hours of your interest and looking at a poorer person, it is your duty to give away zakat. Coming to the Hajj. What is Hajj? Making a holy traveling. Holy traveling. Where to go? All Muslim must go to Mecca and Medina at least once in their lifetime. Once in lifetime. And more than that, they must help again the poorer to accompany them. They must help poorer to accompany them so that they will also can gather a little bit of good thing out of this pilgrimage. Hajj is such a attractive, morally high lifted activity. And coming to the jihad. Jihad is a war against religion. Which religion? They will indulge. In order to protect the Islam, it is a bounded duty of every personality to fight for good cause of the religion. Because we are the entity to look after, safeguard, give security to our own religion. So, against such of the elements, we have to fight. And that is there. But the volume of fighting nature is a little bit higher here in jihad. That should be looked at. So, jihad is where the personalities fight for goodness of the religion. Against the anti-elements. That is there. So these are all the very important five constituent or duties to be performed by an ideal. One is kalma. That is the holy, pious hymn has to be uttered every day, every time for the purification of his own body, soul and mind. Namaz, again the same thing. Where you will pray for the Almighty, very sincerely, faithfully, trustworthy. Next, zakat, yes, it is more than that. Giving is the best nature of thing to be done under the nature. So, zakat, giving away something to the needy person. Hajj is a holy pilgrimage where one will go to Mecca, Medina, and there he will pray there. And it will purify his life. And if he have been accompanied with any other needy person, it's a good cause for the Hajj also. Jihad, it's a war against anti-element to protect the religion. So all these things will all comes under religious injection. So first one is farz or duties where all these five numbers have been ticked. Haram. What do you mean by haram? Haram is not good one. Haram are acts which are strictly being forbidden in the Muslim community. Haram, one should not do. Prostitution is a haram. Again, drinking wines is a haram. In that way, few aspects are there which doesn't allow the true Muslim to go far. Haram is the act which are strictly being forbidden to all the Muslim, at all hours. Like consumption of wine is nothing but a haram. Even one should not go for prostitution and other things. Mandab. Mandab. What do you mean by this one? Mandab, the things which the Muslim are advised to do perfectly at once. The thing which Muslims are being advised to do perfectly at once. That is here only it will come. You can recite kalma any time to your convenience and you can increase in number also. Namaz will also come certain. So manbad are the thing which the Muslims are advised to do. Makruh. What is makruh? M-A-K-R-U-H. What is makruh? The things about which Muslims are advised not to do. That is, it comprises all the scenario of life. For example, to tell you very quickly, there are certain kinds of fish species which one should not eat. That comes at makruh. Makruh is that. And also even many other food varieties and types are there, kinds are there, that they will not eat usually. So that is, makruh is one Muslim must not to carry on. Next, finally, zais. What is zais? Zais are the things which Islam, not Muslim, Islam itself is indifferent. That is, for example, traveling on air or by sea is known as zais. Traveling by air or on sea is known as zais. That is indifferent. That is there. So religious injection is also in five number, whereas to prove oneself as a true Muslim, yes, there are another five. So only by observing these things, a body, any person can become a Muslim. One is kalma, namaz, zakat, hajj and jihad are the duties to be performed and are the first. And again, These are the another four numbers are there: haram, mundub, makruh, and the judge. These are very important for individual. Individual Muslim has to perform. Without this, dividing these things, no, he will not be called as a true Muslim.